श्रीमती रमन गारु We are amidst a commodious small auditorium with a very limited gathering, with very limited resources but unlimited dreams, expectations and ambitions of life. And no doubt, lot of such people, those who have tremendously succeeded in their reputed establishments, they started very limitedly. So whenever some institution or some ideology or some practicality is started with limitations of manpower, mind power and money power, they have been started, many of those things, they have become extinguished institutions, and no doubt very few of them, they have become distinguished institutions. And I believe that this is a small believing as well as a small pathway or a small scintillant spark for an effulgent futuristic distinguished institution, and I hope that it will not extinguish, and there are lot of other hopes as well as the omens, as well as the inner spirit and intuitive guidance, as well as the ideology with which we are going to start this. These all various factors, they unanimously proclaim that there is going to be success, but it may cross few steps and stages of transformation, development and few more sources of integrity and resources. And to start with, naturally human life, you know that it is full of inputs and outputs. We used to gain a lot of things from the outer experience by which the sensory organs that observe each and every happening of the outside and try to inculcate the same inside for any development, for any activity and proceeding. This is what we call entry. That is what we define as pravesha in Sanskrit and the entry in English. That which comes from the outside and gets inside. There is a casual entry in which you just cross into your casual moments of life, used to observe a lot of things and without the intention of making them to be stored in the memory or stored or deeply imprinted in the memory, those things get inside casually. That's known as casual entry. And something that repetitively that wavers inside the mind, and even the capricious mind, it holds something unanimously in a repetitive mode and grasps the same thing. That is known as repetitive entry. That which gets inside and that which has a repetitive hold is known as repetitive entry. That which is due to a circumstantial error or circumstantial nirbandha or balatkara, what we call coercion or compulsion, whatever we do, that is known as coercive entry. And the fourth thing is what we call energetic entry, in which our enthusiasm drives, and also there is a capability of the driving force from the outer element. So there are five entries. And still I don't know how much of the people or how much of the attention can make it easily digestible. And to put it once more, if you casually without the intention, exercise or practice of anything to make to get something enter inside, that is casual. And the second thing is, if something futurally or frequently waves your mind even after the experience, that is known as repetitive or anusmriti. Anusmarana and anusmriti, that is also happening inside. That which is balatkara or coercive, for example, nobody is interested in work, labor, but they are interested in salary. Nobody is interested in education and syllabus, but unfortunately they are interested in the certification and the future developments that they are going to get from that. So this type of coercive entry, by which the persons without realizing the knowledge or rejoicing the wisdom, coercively thrust those syllabus and syllabus content inside, that is known as coercive entry. If you are a capable tool of reception, your enthusiasm will drive how you are remembering all cricket scores, all cine songs, all unwanted elements, how people they are driven to. Because that is driven by enthusiasm, that is known as enthusiastic entry. And the final thing is energetic entry, in which if you are encompassed by a radiant person, spiritually brilliant person, intellectually radiant, effulgent person, a transcendental and preternatural person with more erudition, realization, penetrative radiation and command over language, content, impression and oneness or unison with the concept with this presentation, those who can captivate your hearts, deep sow the seeds of wisdom in your minds, sharpen in your intellect, as well as spiritualize and invigorate your soul, such a person can penetrate into even a stone and to make it realize, he can make even a wooden log to weep. That is known as
energetic entry. So casual entry makes us to remember everything. You know what you have taken today, and you know where are you coming from. That is there in memory, but that is not your intention. It is casual entry. That which you are accustomed to, that is there in memory. That is not a repetitive entry. And your education, syllabus, and various other tasks of life or troubles of life or various other facets of life in which we have to survive to do something, that is known as some entry, which is based on coercion. And enthusiastic entry is driven by your own interest. Energetic entry is the capable bestowal of a preternaturally radiant supernatural person who is beyond all of us, who is beyond all of our accessibility, affordability, and attunability, and who embraces with you with unconditional, unflinching, unalloyed love, mercy, and grade of upliftment that is showering on all of you for your own welfare and well-being. So these things are the basic entries. Likewise, media is also a type of entry. It is also a source of entry inside. So this entry philosophy is the gate for the media industry. How it is there? You want to know something, there is a thing to be known, object, and you are going to know its subject. Between you, you need a mediator. That is known as a medium. The first medium or the first source of medium is consciousness. Your consciousness with ability, intention, and sturdity, it is the first level of apprehension or first level of comprehension. It is the first medium. The medium between this thing as well as the soul is first consciousness. Second medium is what we call language, spirit, or expression, or gesticulation, signals, or symbols. What we call samjna, sanketa, audio and visual. So why it is known as media? Because media has different dimensions. Medium is a connectivity tool between the thing known and the person who is an aspirant of knowledge. And what is that multiplicity or polydimensionalism or pluralism in between these people? It is visual presentation, categorical presentation, allegorical presentation, depictive presentation, narration, dialectical presentation in the form of audio, visual, cacophonical, catastrophic, various other dimensions of constructive and destructive mechanisms are there. This type of multiplicity, multidimensionalism, and polydimensionalism has given the plural name known as media. So media is the connectivity tool or the rajju or sutra between the prameya and pramata. The person who is knowing and the thing that is known is connected by various tools such as sound effect, visual effects, boosting, mounting, pictorial depiction, graphics, processing, color therapy, aroma therapy, expression therapy, various other methodologies are there catering to the need of exploiting or exploring or experimenting the sensational, temptational, and allegorical inner hidden views and feelings of all of the people, by which they are well nurtured, mastered, and commercialized by a media, which is known as media because of its multiplicity. It has various types of sounds, it has various types of forms, it has various concepts, it has various dimensions, it has various methodologies. Even if you take a subject of entertainment, there is a horrible entertainment, there is a comedy entertainment, there is a fiction entertainment, there is a religious fiction entertainment, mytho-fiction entertainment, science fiction entertainment, sports entertainment is there, pure religious ritualistic entertainment is there, suspense thriller is there, shock thriller is there, detective thriller is there, innumerable divisions are there. So this multiplicity of inputs given in various forms on various levels to various people depending upon their invariably variable taste, that is known as media. That is the definition of media where we are going to start with now. So we are in drishya and shravya, the thing that is audible and the thing that is visible, which are connected with pixels and voxels in modern scientific terminology. Pixels in phonoforms and photoforms, they have been given norms as pixels and voxels. Pixel is the photo basic tool or the basic dust, that is known as pixel, you know, pixel cameras. Likewise, voxel is for sound. This is a modern technology and terminology for all of these things. It has started with which is the embryonic primeval element for all of these various emancipations or expressions or expansions. That is from Nataka. Everything has started from Nataka, the external drama. Where this external drama has started from? From your internal dramatic activities. So the drama started first from us, then it was first staged inside our inner mind, then it is staged inside an auditorium, then it was staged in the streets and other places, then those things has been, they have been captivated in the form of a silver screen, small screen, and stage screen, and various other industries that are now flourishing and about to flourish. So it has started from the mind. Mind has three basic instincts. One is vibhava, second is vibhaga, Third thing is prabhav. What is vibhaga? We are having a drama. For example, if you are going to school, then you are acting only the role of a student, not son, daughter, civilian or something else. In the society you are a civilian, in the professional environment you are a professional, in the family you are the component of the family. So domestic, social, academic, professional, neighborhood, spiritual, so we are having innumerable divisions. So we act, that is the first drama, but that is a genuine and realistic drama, that is known as vibhaga. Second thing is vibhava. We are having some money, but yet we say that we don't have, in order to safeguard money or in order to prevent that money going to somebody. So we are just awakened and yet we are saying that we are sleeping, or asking somebody to say that we are sleeping, or even at times foolishly we say that we are sleeping to people. So this is known as vibhava, in which we hide our own feelings and we express something different. That is vibhava. Third thing is prabhava, not for any cheating purpose, but for representation and demonstration purpose. Somebody, they assume a divine disguise, which is known as transfiguration. Iccha sharira grahana. Transfiguration is a bhava by which a person takes a different form. What is rupa vibhava or rupa prabhava? If a person is young, he can take the disguise of an old man, a crippled man, a handicapped man, a clumsy man. These things are rupa. He is acting as an engineer, doctor and other things. So everything is different. His age, his modulation of his voice, his patratva, that is characteristic determination, everything that differs. That is known as transfiguration. That he does with vesha, bhusha, bhasha, rasa, bhava and avarna. That is cinema. What is vesha? That is in disguise. What is bhusha? That is in special tunings. What is bhasha? In modulation and delivery. And what is rasa? The concept or theme that he has taken. Bhava is the expression concurrently and coherently is delivering as per the theme. If the theme is petas and he is laughing unconnectively, that won't be nice. So expression is something connective. Avarna is the background. So these six things are the basic assembly of the nataka industry. There are three rupas. One is bimba rupa, bhava rupa and swarupa. If there is a spectator of a drama, if somebody is crying there, and if that crying person is there in the bimba rupa, just as a shadow, immediately that person will not cry at all. He will not respond at all. But if the same bimba rupa of the actor reflects on the bhava rupa of the person, immediately the person cries, because that intertwines with the person's bhava, the naturality or inherence, and makes the person to feel what the person feels. So if it is in the peripheral coverage, it is unreflected. If it is in the middle coverage, it is reflected. If it mixes with the swarupa, he becomes the same thing. He gets into characteristic identity. There are a lot of killers, psychic killers, who have been very decently or indecently transformed into psychic killers after seeing movies or getting into entertainment contacts. So whenever the bimbarupa is unaffected by the same bimbarupa at the peripheral, it does not make any difference. If it gets into the bhava, the person gets an ephemeral or transient type of feeling. If it gets into the swarupa, the person is affected with the characteristic presentation which deeply penetrates inside the mind of the person. He becomes the character at all, whether it is salubrious or pernicious to him or the society is different. So it gets inside. This is the rule. So more than the other tools of experience, number one, our own experience. Number two, narration or depiction which we have from people. Third thing, observation of other people. All of these things are very limited. How can we observe a lot of things? How can we experience a lot of things? How we can get things through imagination? How far we can derive from the narration of others? So cinema or nataka or media is the fifth tool, which is known as pradarshana or effective demonstration, in which all the other gaps and defects of the other tools of imagination, observation, narration or depiction and experience can be totally settled and reconciliated, by which a perfect consummate structure of a complete and holistic experience can be brought out. That is the greatness of this media industry. Psychologically, we must understand psychology, commercial psychology and social psychology, without which nobody can start a channel. Even if they start a channel, they cannot run a channel without understanding the trend of the society and the mindset of the society. There are innumerable things we used to call in the Shastras as various divisions or angas. For example, there is Keli, Niti, Natya, Nataka, Kala, Vidya, Adhyatma, Prachara, Vichara, Krishi, Prakriti. Innumerable things are there. Prachara, Vichara, Krishi, Prakriti. Innumerable things are there. These divisions now we are seeing. National Geographic Channel, what is it? It is Prakriti. Krishi channel is there, Krishi divisions are there, KLE sports channels are there, Adhyatma channel, Samskar Astra channels are there. So whatever we are seeing now, these are all common divisions of the society and the social or societal taste catering to which they have been made. And what is the phala and what is the present contemporary nishpala or futility? The utility of these channels are darshana, bodhana, protsahana, shamana, prerana. They are known as panchanga or panchopaya. There are five major reasons for which we are doing all of these things. First thing is darshana. We are showing lot of things. For what purpose? Bodhana, to educate them. What is the type of education? Prerana, to direct them in the right path. Shamana, to settle or extinguish or extirpate the unwanted vibrations or unwanted connotations inside their mind. And the fifth thing is protsahana, to keep them always energetic, by which they can achieve the things. That is why it is known as recreation. Anybody, those who are already creative, their creativity is obstructed by means of their exhaustion. That energy loss is compensated by a process of recreation, by which they are compensated, they are complemented, they are compassionately embraced by means of a vital induction, by which they effectively do the work 10 times more than the productivity with which they have been working. But that is not now. With the present media industry, it is acting in a different way. Kriyahari, Buddhihari and Kalahari. It is a voracious consumer of time. It is a criminal waste of time. So it is Kalahari. It totally corrupts the human intellect and mind. That's why it is known as Buddhihari and Kriyahari. It does not energize your work. Totally your work level or the performance grade or rate of your success will be spoiled or diminished. That is the present media. Because of lack of few things. What is that? Standard of reality and recreation. What is reality and what is recreation? How far they can be implemented? I want to put five golden rules for media industry. Number one, media, there is one taste. You know that there is a taste bud. In your tongue, there is a consumptive taste bud. Likewise, in your mind, there is an aesthetic taste bud. The duty of the media is to lead the society's aesthetic taste bud to a proper direction, not to feed their aesthetic taste buds. If you feed their aesthetic taste buds whatever they like, then the society will be corrupt and collapse. No doubt you can develop, but not the society. Your development is at the cost of sacrificing the values of the society. So lead the society, don't feed the society. They are too immature to ask or to select what they want and what that is good for them. They are very immature. So feed the society by means of which you can lead them. Don't just feed them as per the taste. That is the first rule. Second thing is, there are three vairis or antagonistic factors to media or even normal human ethicism or principles. One is vulgarism. Second thing is violence. And third thing is obscenity. And depiction of immorality or impresent or improportionate depiction of morality. These things are also other brotherhood defects inside that. So vulgarity, violence and obscenity must be totally prevented, and there is also a pretext. It is known as pretext of the story structure. What is it known as? Pretext of the story structure. The story is like that, so we have to show. This is the excuse of most of the people. How it is there? Even if you have to show, there is a decent way of showing it. You must not show more cruelty. Prolonged depiction must not be done. Detailed depiction must not be done. Close-up shots must not be made. This is the morale of even the story structure where you have to do these things. What is the impact of these things on society? It has created a new faculty known as imitative criminology. What is imitative criminology or media tutorial? Media tutorial and imitative criminology is on seeing the cinemas, instead of learning that it is unethical or the villain is shot dead, the person will natively or naturally think how to do the same villain's work and not to get killed. That becomes the crooked mentality or intellect of the viewers or spectators. They want to be the villains or do something. And if there is some mistake in the villain's depiction or execution in the cinema, they try to avoid it. So the crooked intellect of the society wants to do the same activities, prohibited heinous activities, with a safety mechanism or safety engineering methodology of criminal executions. So they want to derive a safety engineering technique for doing their criminal activities. So in this situation, as the society is very immature for selection, option, abdication and accustomation, in this stage we have to tune things as per our own moral and ethics, not as per the demand of the society. This is known as media ethics. Generally we used to call it as media ethics. And we used to have pratyekika, and Aneka. What is Pratyeka? Exclusive channel for exclusive things like Samskar TV and ESPN, etc. And we are having Aneka means multidimensional or polystructural channel in which we can have everything. We can have a slot or we can have a mainframe, whatever it may be. These are all the various things involved now. I want to conclude this session by saying that what are all the things that are supportive of starting a new channel and what are all the hindering factors and how we have to proceed. These three things will be in the concluding session of my speech. Number one, public participation. If public is invited just to show their faces or speak there or dance there or demonstrate there, just showing the space, just being inside the cyberspace or the telespace itself is considered to be a very great pride and prestige. It is considered to be a royal honor to the modern citizens of the country. So public participation, number one. Number two is incentives. Give lot of incentives. Even if it is an aluminium tumbler, if it is given in a stage, that has its own value. So the worthy element has its worthiness only on the area, environment and personality where the things are distributed, not on their market cash value or the cost value. So these things, they gain more benefit. So incentives. Third thing is temptation feast. Whatever the children they like, whatever the housewives they like, we have to feed them. That is temptation feast. That's what now going on. The fourth thing is staging. That is known as icon staging. The more icons are staging inside your telespace, more it will be visualized by people and appreciated by them. There may be two types of icons, ascendants and descendants. Those who are coming from the stage screen to the small screen, they are known as ascendants. Those who come from the silver screen to the small screen, they are known as descendants. So these two people, they are known as icons, they are staged. So these things are the various possible methodologies. Temptation showering, staging of icons, as well as public participation with more incentives. That's what we are doing now. And for that we need money and also political favor, support and machinery. There are a lot of politically favoring TVs. There are a lot of supported TVs. There are a lot of political machineries in the form of TVs as a propaganda tool at all. This is how the media works. And what are all the things that are there ethically possible by us, some unexplored but explorable and to be experimented and experienced regions that are there in the military industry. We have to see that. So it is a very powerful thing and it is as vigorous as any other tool. Generally, negative things, they are getting more power. Positive things are not like that. To harm your finger, the fire will take only 10 seconds, but the burner will take 10 days for getting its effect. So this is the nature. So how to have a positive or powerful or ethical way, what are all the possibilities to get it in a media center, in a military area? We have to take a military impact or a military procedure or a warfoot methodology. Number one, infinity innovation theory. Infinity of innovation is, there are innumerable innovations in the world. Innovations have come, the space of knowledge has uncounted innovations newly. If we think positively, sit together and discuss, we can get more innovations. That is known as innovative infinity theory. And number two theory is value revival theory. Whenever the value is diminished, there will be a dawn once again from the dusk. So value will be revived. This second theory is also comforting us. The third thing is law of diminishing interest, which comes in commerce and economics also. The people are totally diminished in interest, monotonously, tediously seeing those things where people are either crying, frying or dying. These things are the majorly seen things in the media, and seeing all of these things, the people are frustrated, totally depressed. Somebody asked why, if the things are very monotonous, somebody asked me why they are seeing the TV. I told four reasons. Number one, if they are seeing the TV, that means that their aesthetic taste buds are very limited, are very mean, that's why they are able to relish. And number two, they are very much seeing because they don't have any other go. That is a simple and proximate availability. The third thing is, that must have been their own life or connected with them. That's why they are very involved in seeing. Without involvement, they cannot see. If there is an involvement, there must be some intimacy, content intimacy between the thing happening with your own life. The fourth thing is very cruel. It shows that if they are seeing something boresome, if they are seeing something boresome, it clearly depicts how much more boresome their life will be. So I told these things are the four reasons by which they are getting into watching of this TV. So it is known as law of diminishing interest, by which the society is now diminishing in interest, number three. Number four is middle gap theory. What is middle gap theory? There is a big gap between the expectation of the society as well as the things that are given now. As the right thing is not given, they have to tolerate with what it is given. Somebody has to psychologically analyze these things and fill up the gap. There is a big gap available for us. That is known as middle gap theory. Number fifth, the positive counter theory. If somebody shows violence and indecent romanticism or principles of comedianism, we can just replace the same thing by decent comedy, real comedy. Interesting comedy, instructive comedy, informative comedy, we can make it like that. Positive encounter, how to fill the same thing through a positive counter, that is known as positive counter theory. Then triple T theory, that is target, technique and teamwork theory. How to make a target of the people, how to make a proper teamwork, and how to make the technicalities available by which we can reach the society. Personal reach theory, how to reach the persons directly in their homes and make them very much involved. The other thing is benefit reach theory or benefit way theory or benefit way model. There is one TV in Tamil Nadu known as Makkal TV. They don't show any cinema or cine songs. They are totally against cinema industry. They are showing things about stock exchange, investments, construction, events of national and international importance, then vyavasaya, agriculture, horticulture, and any other thing that is connected with the development of the society, only with the hita part, not priya part, not which they like, that which benefits is concentrated and it is running successfully, no doubt with political support also, but it is known as benefit way model. So these things are the models before us. So now what we have to do immediately is to get a sanction, uplink, de-link, connectivity, then slot and other things are different. Those things are very procedural. Now what we have to do is, we have to have a library of lot of collections ready. See, only current affairs are to be depicted or relayed on that one day. That same day, only we have to relay the news and other things which are connected to the current affairs or day-to-day affairs or something temporally connected. We can take concerts, interviews, because we have to say something known as Pratyekika, Pratidarshana, Bada, Sambada, Bodha. So we can take interviews, we can take discussions, we can take music and dance, concerts, we can take all of those things like temple festivals and functions, we can take everything in the form of documentaries and have our own stuff or stock for at least 6 months. And number two, very simple way and effective way I am saying, to reach the public, we have to organize lot of festivals on connected issues with media, arts and social issues. We have to connect lot of stage performances. We have to conduct lot of stage performances with various other enthusiastic and encouraging procedures by which we are awarding the people and we are honoring some people. We are giving prizes to the students. Like that, we have to have connectivity with the present print and electronic media by conducting festivals, workshops, functions and award ceremonies on various issues. That's why we are becoming very much related and proximated to the society by which we will get lot of people in connectivity. Like we will get investors, we will get supporters, we will get technicians, we will get good idealists or principle oriented theories we can get lot of volunteers and working people, we can get lot of talented people who can commit something productively in our team. So to get that, to get public affiliation, affinity, popularity and prosperity, we have to go with the present media, print and electronic media, in organizing at least monthly function that caters to the need. And it must be connected with some NGO, connected with physically handicapped, mentally retarded, then slum development, tribal development, etc., so that it will get social attraction, so that the name will be very much familiarized. The name popularity is very much important. So from this day, we have to start shooting off small documentaries which are effectively at any time they can be utilized. Number two, we have to connect with society by conducting a lot of seminars and workshops and media related programs by which we will be familiar in the society to get more input. By doing this, we can get the really marketability. My marketability in the invitation is on my photo. My market exposure spiritually or by my divine wish or by my real and genuine prayer, I may be more valuable. But regarding the market, my value is lesser than the value of a 2.5 rupees of detergent soap. So, what is market attraction, market target and market projection? We have to project those people with the silent revolutionary and evolutionary showers of our blessings. You have to take care of the projection value of the market or the society, because it is an immature society. Till they become mature, mature people cannot be projected. I am not saying that I am mature in this context. So I wish and bless the Vidisha a very great grand success commercially, informatively, and also having a transformative value of the society without compromising the present people. They are vexed with their wife and children, vexed with their office and schools, vexed with the society and government. They need a proper entertainment, attunement and enlightenment. For that, we have to give a very, very conducive and admirable model. I think that very intellectually, prudently, psychologically, this Vidisha will approach the society. Even time may be taken more, but the target will be achieved. I wish and bless that it will be achieved very soon with the help of all of you. And we have to take this mission in various parts of the land to get a composite and integral strength for this Vidisha as a national body, not just as a media body. Narayan, Narayan, Narayan.